Talking to you, David.
Thank you. That was Sarah Bush, who says she wants to die. Thank you. That's most of my listeners. Joining us is Pete Dominick. Hello there, Pete Dominick.
David, thank you. Hi, everybody. Thank you. Thank you very much. So good to be back. Shana Tova.
Yes, I dated her in high school.
Oh, you did?
She lives in Long Island.
I hooked up with an Orthodox gal when I was like 21, and she kept telling me how she was going to get in a lot of trouble, and she felt very, very guilty. And while we were naked, I said, see, lightning didn't strike, everything's fine, and I shit you not, the ceiling fan fell.
And it just shredded the white sheet with the hole in it. give you a straight answer about that. We've talked about that in the past. Pete Dominick, I trashed you. I started this show in a bad mood. I'm going to tell you, because I'm a beta male and you're an alpha, and I'm cowering now because I said, what's so hard about showing up on time? Mm-hmm. I made fun of you for being a half hour late. And now that I see you and I realize you can turn my head into a pulpy paste, I'm backing down and apologizing immediately.
Well, I pride myself on being on time. And last night you said 6:30. I've got a paper trail. I'm looking at the email. 6:30. Confirmed.
Right.
So, I mean, just to be clear, you can trash me all you want, but really you're pointing back at yourself. And mm-hmm. I mean, if I could share my screen, I would show everybody the email where we confirmed the time.
And so I was angry at myself.
Yeah, I would imagine. And then and then about 20 minutes before the show began, I said, David, I'm confused. You've got me on the lineup at 6, but we confirmed 6:30. And I might be able to move something. And I still didn't hear back from you until the time when you thought I was supposed to be here. So, you know,
I know it's my fault, but I'm still mad at you.
Okay. Well, I'm
mad at you.
Well, I bet you had a better time without me anyway.
No. I wanted you on. By the way, thank you, Sarah, for filling in for Pete Dominick.
It's probably better anyway.
No. Well, yes, of course. She has three cats named Michael, Jamal, and Brooks.
Oh, that's interesting. Those are names that you would generally think of as humans. And I always think it's funny when people name their animals names that are more likely to be humans. Like David. No,
they're named after Michael Brooks.
Oh, okay.
And his middle name was Jamal.
Hey, Michael Brooks, who just passed away? That Michael
Yes,
Brooks?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Did you know him?
Yes, I did. Yeah.
I didn't know him, but I was a big fan.
Yes, yes. No. Well, hang on. Okay. You're an alpha male. Mm-hmm. And I wanted you at the top of the show because you watched that debate on Tuesday night.
Yeah, yeah.
Did Biden come across as an alpha male? You say that other alpha males can sniff out other alpha males.
No. He came across as a doddering beta. No. He didn't. He came across as a guy who was overthinking all of it and decided that he didn't want to be angry until he could no longer, I think, hold it when Trump attacked his son at one point. But no, I felt like at the beginning of the debate, I tweeted, Trump is absolutely killing Joe Biden, just killing him. And Biden had no idea what to do. And it was surprising to me that he wasn't prepared for that. That was very surprising to me. Because my pre-debate criticism was that Biden would be so prepared and have all these canned lines, and I would cringe as he rolled them out. But that wasn't the case at all. He was completely flustered. He couldn't finish his points because, you know, Trump kept throwing him off. And obviously, Trump is an alpha. And I think beta.
And is that important to you as an alpha dog? Are you looking for?
No.
Do you think the president has to be an alpha dog?
No. I think the president has to be a listener and has to be a confident person. Alphas are mostly, you know, fairly insecure, and which is why they have to be the way people like me tend to be, with anger and lashing out. And what we need in a leader is someone who listens and someone who's able to delegate. And I think that Biden will do a great job. I actually think Biden will be a great president because he's not an alpha and because he's always been been smart at surrounding himself with smarter people. I think Obama was a great president because his personality was not that of an alpha. He was extremely confident, and he didn't need to project anger, and he didn't need to do so many of the things that we alphas do to overcompensate.
Right. We're going to have the Hirschenfelds. Dr. Philip Hirschenfeld is coming up at 7. He's a psychiatrist. And we can talk about Trump's paranoia. I think that's the biggest facet, the most dangerous component of his mental illness is the paranoia, which comes with delusion. The malignant narcissism, I'm not so worried about, although that's a symptom. Paranoia is a symptom of malignant narcissism. You're an alpha male.
Yeah.
What little I know about alpha males is you can spot them as puppies.
Yes.
You can go and they're born. That suggests that alpha males don't necessarily have a psychological disorder.
I don't know about that. I thought you meant you could spot them in a crowd, not that you can spot them when they're young. I think that I developed into what I am. And a lot of it had to do with being the smallest kid in high school and desperately not wanting to be bullied. And so I wasn't going to be able to physically fight my way.
Are you small?
I was. Now people, I don't think, look at me as, I mean, now I'm average. I'm 5'8", 145 pounds with a body fat percentage that throws off my monthly menstruation. I mean, I'm really ripped. But when I was in high school, I was tiny. I was the smallest kid. As a senior, I was still the smallest kid in school. And that's why I'm a comedian. And that's why a lot of things for me. And so I developed my personality to be able to fend off conflict and to be able to dominate in a conversation or in a group so that I could get ahead of the other alphas, the bullies, the big guys. And you also notice that there, every once in a while you'll meet a really large man who's has never been in a fight in his life because he didn't need to be, you know, and I always find that fascinating. Whereas a lot of small people like myself had to develop that kind of, you know, persona that I still have to feel like I need, which I don't. I've started to shed it from time to time.
Right. Well,
and I married an alpha.
And you did marry an alpha.
Yes.
But not a dog. Hell yeah. But not a dog.
Yes.
So yes. I won't do the bitch joke. Well,